And we're back for game two in this best of three showdown. It's your lower bracket finals here for the Dota 2 Asia Championships America qualifier. We'll take a quick look at those brackets for those who have not been following the tournament up until now. All you really need to know at this point is that Complexity and Fire, winner of this best of three, will go on to play Cloud9 in the grand finals. And of course, with that said, I'm LD. Welcome to the cast. I'm joined here by Merlini. Ben, Complexity looking a lot stronger today.
Their draft's been a lot better, too. I think it's still a mistake giving Brew. Even given the amount of nerfs that he's received recently, he's still very, very strong. And just not someone that you really want to deal with. So Fire, we see first pick Juggernaut. It was not banned by Complexity. And I think there's two ways to approach Juggernaut. One, you can like disable him with instant stuns and just kill him. Or have like a lot of physical damage and Blink Basher or something like that. Or you can push like C9 did yesterday. That's the two most viable ways to deal with him since he's been picked a lot more recently. And we see Fire ban out the Drow Ranger. I mean, Complexity didn't really have... I mean, I guess it could have pushed with a Puck and a Bane, but these aren't your ideal like push heroes. So I don't think I'd be too scared of the Drow ban or of the Drow pick.
Yeah, it can be kind of a... It's like, if we're going to lose...
Whoops, my bad.
I definitely agree that it's also not like a go-to Complexity strat, but at the same time, it's just a very aggravating way to end up losing a game. Like, you don't want to go into a draft and then, oh crap, they picked Drow and we weren't prepared for it and now we just lose. So I guess Fire just kind of playing this one safe. We're gonna see that Puck versus Lion matchup though, and curious to see if it's actually an offlane Puck, if they look to just send this mid for Byver, as I don't think we've seen him play it yet in the past 2 days. But we have seen the offlane Pucks really struggle against the Lion, so very curious how they're going to look to lane this one.
I think Puck in general just struggles versus Lion, mid or offlane.
Yeah, and Lion has been a very popular pick as of late, which maybe is part of the reason why we're seeing a little less Puck. Sand King now banned out by Fire. Sand King and Earthshaker were two big playmakers for Fire yesterday. They don't want to give one away here to Complex. They already have their 5 position likely in this Bane pickup. Now banning out the Venomancer, we've seen TC and IX Mike play this over the past few weeks. We did see a support Veno actually yesterday from Fluff, so I guess there's always the possibility they could throw that one in the mix again. Pick.
You know, Fire could actually push with Juggernaut too. That's one of the uses of Juggernaut that we haven't seen too much in this patch, but was very popular and prevalent a couple of patches ago, especially with like the likes of Lone Druid, Chen. Still a pretty good one, but I think they would have banned out an AA if they were going for that.
Yeah, the banning out the Drow definitely... it can be a hero that used the split push and counter pushing strat, but doesn't really seem like they're particularly hell-bent on it. And they don't have to be. They can play...
Ha, hell-bent. They have Lion.
Like that. Reserve time. That really amused you?
It did.
Okay, good. Let's see. Third pick now. Ooh, something spicy here. Complexity going to bring out the sniper. Now, I believe this was run once yesterday. It was against we were not cast.
It was not only run yesterday in Dota 2 Asia Championship, it was also run in the D2L. So, sniper is... I don't think he's that great versus Juggernaut. I think one of the best parts about sniper is that he can just pick off the healing ward really easily, which is actually a tremendous amount of heal. But I think like a blank Juggernaut will just own a sniper really badly. So we'll see if Fire can make this one work.
Yeah, now this hero did get a couple of big changes. For those who haven't seen him, Shrapnel completely reworked almost. It doesn't damage buildings, but you have the 3 charges now and a 40-second replenish time on them. Mana cost has gone from 120 all the way down to 50, and it lasts a second longer, so... Not quite as good at taking towers with Shrapnel, but still ridiculously good at D-pushing and just being annoyed and creating like the zone where heroes are a bit slower and just less effective in team fights.
I'd say it's much worse for laning, it's much better for team fights.
Yeah.
And obviously much worse for sieging towers.
Yeah, he used to have that kind of mini Dragon Knight effect where just if you just put a mid, the tower's slowly going to die. Just throw a Shrapnel out occasionally, similar to Dragon Knight, just alt, right-click it once in a while. Eventually it will fall, but Complexity now, getting the sniper, generally when we see this hero, you have to worry about him getting caught. And Fire have picked 3 heroes that can be very good at catching the sniper out. You mentioned the Blink Jug, now there's a Clockwork as well. Yeah, I think that there's a lion.
I think they could have gone with a sniper pick much later if they had really wanted to. Sniper, I don't really view as like super easy to counter. It's just you don't want to reveal him until later.
Yeah, and now Fire, having seen it early, they've got all kinds of ways to catch him out. So we'll see if Complexity... They have the defensive sleep from Bane, but they don't have like a great solution. And generally, you want to see those tanky initiator frontliners to keep the heat off of him. Complexity, find one now in the Slardar.
This has
been a virtually forgotten hero.
This is... I don't remember which D2L game it was yesterday, but it was definitely a sniper and a Slardar in the game, too. It might have been... I'll have to double check the replays, but they were clearly watching one of these games.
Yeah, changes to Slardar in this patch will sprint duration has gone from 20 to 16, but the cooldown has gone from 28 to 3, and amp damage has half the cooldown, similar to the change to track, where you could basically just be spamming the spell all the time. Obviously, Slardar gives you great Roshan potential. But Fire are also really good at just scouting out the pit and being annoying around there. The Zeus ult, the Thunderbolts to kind of give you a little extra bit of vision and dewarding, and the Clockwork with rockets and hooks flying out. So they may want to go for Roshan Complexity, but it won't be easy.
Mm-hmm.
Fifth ban now going to come out for Complexity. At this point, Fire could still be that mid Zeus, though. We saw it in the support role in the last game, and assuming they go a support way again, they look to ban out...
Oh, Complexity actually ran it yesterday. They ran almost the exact same lineup. It was Puck, Bane, Slardar, Sniper, and Enigma as their last, versus a Juggernaut.
Yeah, if they go... Let's see if... At this point, they do need their four-position supports. So they could go into an Enigma here.
5 seconds remaining.
Now, there's a Clockwork and a Juggernaut, so... A bit irritating for him. Oh,
Dire team pick.
Just wanting to make sure this Juggernaut's more effective, and also a bit worried about the grouping up of Complexity.
So Slardar is interesting versus Juggernaut too, because he actually has a pretty good way to catch out Juggernaut with the blink stun. He's like an initiator / carry, and on top of that, he can actually just own him during the Blade Fury too.
You amp him just immediately after. Him.
Well, he can also chase him down, too. Most of the time, Juggernaut's like, okay, I spin, I run away, you run away, and you can't really do damage to me. But with sprints, and if you get one bash, he is pretty much dead on the spot.
And the whole time, the goal for Complexity is you've Sniper just laying into the Juggernaut from distance. So now they have Fiend's Grip, as well as the Slardar bash, and the pretty instant stuns coming out as well, with the Sniper there to kite and control him a bit. This Juggernaut, maybe not going to have the easiest time. We did see the Juggernaut pick struggle once yesterday against the Drow, and, well, one way to get heavy right-click is just get a lot of plus damage with the Drow, but another way to do it is to get this minus armor from Slardar. So kind of a similar idea in some ways to what we saw yesterday.
I think they could easily go with the Enigma again, because Fire doesn't really have that much anti-push right now, too. Lion and the Omni. That is going to be ridiculously difficult for the Juggernaut to deal with.
Yeah, now you've got... I guess you almost have to go Diffusal Blade now.
Yeah, but if you go Diffusal first, it's...
Well, yeah, maybe not first, but pretty early.
But if he does, if he goes Diffusal later, I think Omni Knight will still be, like, really strong with a Slara. And Slara is almost going to certainly get a BKB anyways, so it's not even that great of a solution to the Omni Knight. But
it is a great solution to Fire,
this
Omni Knight pick. Going to be tough for them, and generally when we see the Omni Knight picks, where they seem to struggle is if your team just gets wrecked in the laning stage, but can Fire really get that done with this what looks like potentially a support Lion Zeus?
They could aggro try, but definitely not. I keep thinking that they might run Zeus mid, but looks like they're pretty
support Zeus again.
Yeah, they're pretty content with that.
Kind of similar to last game in some ways. You've got a very nuke heavy supporting cast here for the Juggernaut. Lion, Zeus, Invoker. Do you think this will be the Quas Wex Invoker? Do you go for more of your like carry?
Well, Quas Wex is pretty useless versus Omni. So I think if they have a Quas Exort Invoker, it's a lot better. I think also Quas Exort is a little bit more TC's playstyle. Like the repelled Slaughter has so many good targets. Like none of them can do anything versus the repel except Juggernaut. And even then, it's just an Omni Slash.
And then there might be an Omni Knight ult anyway to bail him out.
Yeah, so that's dubious. I'm not really liking Fire's chances here.
Well, let's see if anyone can get off to a hot start and take this game over for them. As we get underway, guys, the draft now complete. Game 2 begins. And we introduce Complexity. Yesterday they got 2-1 by Fire. Today, though, they look strong. They look confident. Taking game 1 in a convincing way with the Spectre teamfight heavy lineup for Protect 1. Now going for something with more of a tri-core here. We're going to have the Sniper for Byver going mid lane. Limp going to be playing the puck off lane with Sensational on the cogs and on the Clockwork, and now looking to reprise his role on this puck. Moomiander, really good play on that Disruptor last game. Let's see if he can get it done again on the Bane. He'll be trying to set up for Swindle Melons here playing the Slardar, and that will round things out for Complexity with Z-Freak on the Omni Knight. As for Fire, IX Mike, offlane Clockwork, one of his go-to heroes. Fogged, going to be playing that Lion again. Ush on the Juggernaut, the hero that's been tearing it up pretty much all around the world in this latest patch, and a pub nightmare to deal with as well. Fluff, going to be taking the role of the Zeus, and that leaves TC with the early Blades of Attack on the Invoker.
I was looking at the pregame chat. They were talking about how... No idea how you saw that coming, so apparently they were... I'm not sure how confident they were in actually picking the Chen, but
why Chen over like the Enigma there? Because that was also available, I believe.
Maybe just running what C9 did yesterday.
Okay.
With the heal, and it's just more sustained push rather than having to rely on pretty weak Eidolons.
Complexity making their way up towards the mid lane now. Moonmeander, Z-Freak, Swindle together. Wrap around back down to the runes. Just doing a bit of a scouting mission here. Won't come across anything. They're going to be facing off against IX Mike, who does eat a tree here just to give himself a place to block in some creeps potentially. And with that, he should at least be able to get the creeps back to where he wants them early on. Getting a pretty good block so far. So it's going to be a mid sniper versus the invoker. And sniper just not even getting a block off at all. Creeps are going to be up on the enemy high ground. Actually, in tower range. Well, this is awkward for TC.
Looks like a Quas Wex, though. I was wrong.
Yeah, going for the Blades of Attack first. Denied. Kind of your class. It used to be, you know, we'd see like that Phase Drums, Yules, Quas Wex Invoker every game back around TI2, and this was the way it would generally start with the early Blades of Attack. Just give you a little extra right click, help you CS when your damage is awful early on, and once you get the Phase Boots, it gets a lot easier.
There's a Fog trading a couple hits with Limp. Limp still has more base damage, even after that base damage buff on Lion.
Still not easy to trade blows with a puck in general. But once they get the level 2 on Lion, that's where things could get scary for him. They do have a Zeus back.
They don't have enough burst, though. Like, Juggernaut's spin is really good, but not versus getting a puck.
Definitely not at this stage of the game. Maybe when their Zeus gets like level 3 to 5, they may be able to go for something, but they're not going to be able to keep Limp out of the lane fully at this point. And he is going to start stealing neutrals. These level starved, level hungry supports, not going to have an easy time getting them against Limp. He's just done a good job 2 games so far of just keeping the supports busy in the off lane, not letting Fogged and Fluff just freely pull. And since Fire continue to run supports that need those levels, it's definitely hurting them a lot.
Well, Z-Freak's able to get his experience. Really important as an Omni Knight. See, I mean, he's only level 2, though.
Look at this. Like, they two of them had to chase Limp all the way back up here just to get the rune. And it will be a bounty rune for Fluff, so definitely much appreciated. Space created, though.
Slardar might be like a Boots Blink Rush, too. It depends on how early they want to fight. I think, ideally, you want to fight when, like, Omni Knight's level 9, and that might be a little bit too early for Slardar to actually, like, kill people. If he gets his Blink, it might be too early for him to kill people on his own, since he won't have that high of a level of repel.
Yeah, we've seen... I think it was... Goblack's old team was running the Slardar for a while, and sometimes Illidan would often just go like Treads Vanguard early. We wouldn't even necessarily see the Blink Dagger Rush, but there's quite a few ways to play the hero. We've seen Armlet on occasion, though not too often. pretty flexible in terms of item builds, but
I think blink is mandatory though.
Yeah, aside like from they, that, you would always go for a blink. It just might. It wasn't always like the first item.
Well, you can go like Midas blink. You can go like Treads blink. You can just go Boots blink. You can even go no Boots blink since he has sprint.
In theory, the puck can be that initiator, but when Limp's in the off lane, that's where the Slardar getting his blink early becomes more important. Similar to running like the safe lane centaurs that we've seen more of over the past couple months. Generally, they'll get the very fast
blink. I'm sure he could go like early Vlad's too to do Roshan if they don't actually want to fight that often too. So
and they have a good.
There are more options.
Yeah. Definitely a lot of options. Byver. So far, look, we'll take a look at our sniper's mid-performance so far. Up against the Quas, Wex, and Bunker.
Oh, TC!
Oh, he's gonna go for this one! Turns on! Wow. Ends up getting the first blood, right-click down by Byver. TC did not have any easy way to disengage there. No Tornado, unfortunately. And
where is the Tornado? That's strange.
Yeah, he had the... I didn't actually see if he invoked EMP just then, or if he already had it.
Usually you'll see Tornado and Cold... yeah, I think Tornado and Cold Snap invoked. And then you can EMP after. I guess it depends on what you're doing as your Quasuck Invoker. But if you're ever afraid of dying, you should not have EMP. You should have Tornado and Cold Snap.
He was bullying Byver quite a lot earlier. Now Assassinating TC just casual harass. That'll force out the first tango or the last tango, I should say.
I also think he should have went for a 3-1 build with 3 in Quas and 1 in Wex. If you're struggling, you need the regen, and he clearly did not have enough regen to survive.
They're going to go for a Tornado EMP, though. This will connect. Detonate Hex Byver, and with that, it looks like they'll get a much easier kill, slowing down that sniper. Still, it forces out a rotation, but level 4 from Fog. And this after the puck was slowing down the supports quite a bit in that safe lane. Big kill there for Fire.
Yeah, nice Tornado hit.
It was like, very close to him being able to just dodge it, but caught him slightly off guard. If that Tornado doesn't hit, he lives there. Even forced out the Omni Knight rotation, but Z-Freak will get some levels out of this.
I mean, there's a lot of... I'm still surprised at the Invoker pick. Like, Puck can just phase shift out of the Quasuex Invoker. It is just very useless versus the Omni Knight Repel 2s. I mean, I guess you have a lot of move speed. Maybe you can kite a sprinting Slardar, but that's pretty far-fetched. It is pretty good at maybe catching a Sniper and disabling a Bane, but I think there are other heroes for that. So,
and there's also, I mean, some point, as you mentioned, he's going to have BKB. There's still the Repel to worry about, especially even if you get a Diffusal Blade, like, you're not going to preemptively be able to use that, so. I guess it's just looking for TC to be roaming around the map with the Orchid in the mid-game and Ghostwalk, trying to find pickoffs for the Zeus and Clockwork. It seems like that may be the idea here for Fire.
Yeah, but they already have Clockwork for that. Clockwork doesn't need another way to initiate. I think, if anything, he needs more damage with a Quas Exort Invoker.
Yeah.
So he can solo kill like a Bane pretty quickly, an Omni Knight.
Sniper is also just a hard hero to lane against in general if you're not getting ganks and you're not someone who can jump him. And going Quas Wex, it makes it hard to CS. And TC, as you can see, is getting wrecked in that department. Down 11, last hits, 5 experience. Uh-oh, top lane. Onto Ike Smike. At the same time, there's a wrapper on bottom lane. Ike Smike will fall, and now they're going to catch out Limp as well, but he tries to make his way out with the orb. Can't jaunt in time. And we get our answer, Ben. It's going to be an early Midas picked up here on the Slardar.
I think it's... It shores up their late game for sure. I'm not against it, especially since it's this early. Again, I don't really think he can get that much accomplished with the blink. TC, oh, that was
big
close.
Pressure as TC almost gets assassinated here, but just manages to get off a Tornado. And while that was going on, the Omni Knight bottom ends up falling as well. Fire starting to really get back into this game, making the score 3-2.
Radiance middle tower.
And the good news for them is, although Slardar has gone Midas, with this, he won't really be applying too much pressure to them, and it'll give them a bit of breathing room.
Yeah, but at the same time, he's going to hit that stretch, like the 25-minute mark. If he has, like, Blink Dezo and Treads and Repel, he can just own these heroes. Like, Lion still has 1 armor. Clockwork has almost no armor, too. He has 2 armor. Zeus also has 2 armor. So all these heroes are just really, really weak to Slardar's physical damage. And on top of that, and the sniper beating on them.
Yeah, Fire look like they want to be fighting and dominating before it gets to that point. Going Quasuex Invoker, getting an early Mask of Madness out on Usher's Juggernaut, not going for anything more farm-oriented, although you can farm quite a bit faster with the Mask of Madness, but really benefits you in terms of solo kill potential.
And they have no anti-BKB.
And he is going for a different build. I think, yeah. Did he play Jug yesterday? The Jugs that we saw yesterday were not going this build. They were going to the Blade Fury max, leveling up the Healing Ward early. The hero's in an interesting place where there's a lot of different ways to experiment. And Ush will try for something different. Gets this bounty room. May try to sneak the Rosh at some point, but not ready to go for that yet.
He did it yesterday with Treads and Mask. Madness.
Attack speed, obviously. Oh, Limp. This is not good. Gets caught out. Quick zap from Fog.
Moon. Invis.
And now looking for a bit more.
He's only level 4, though.
They do have an Omni, but... yeah, also only level 4. But if Ixmike walks up this far, this could be trouble. Swindle begins to sprint on in. And no, we don't want to see a fight reset. Thank you very much, Dota 2. Ixmike, surrounded. And beaten down. Nice quick kill there for Complexity. They have Omni Slash ready for Ush. He may go for something again soon. Not easy against the Puck, but if they get off that quick Hex, then that should be enough time to get the kill. And while that's happening, Moon and Z-Freak are on the smoke. They make their way towards mid, maybe wanting to go for TC here. Now gonna back off Moomiander. Now they decide to TP in the sniper bottom, not wanting to give up this tower. It's now been glyphed. Fire. Gonna take it one way or the other. Ush starts to get destroyed. Auto-attacked quite hard by the sniper, but with the healing ward there, he's able to stay alive. So the tower goes down, no deny, and it forces out a sniper rotation early.
Fire. So it looks like Invoker will be going for an Orchid. I guess maybe Invoker is the main Omni Knight controller in the fights, too.
Yeah, unless your Lion gets super fat, but... remember, actually, yes. Fogged has a blink. Wow. 2,300 gold. This is looking more like the games where they dominated. He had a really fast blink in all of those. Mm-hmm. Or all two of them, I should say. Both of them.
Clockwork smoked on bottom, but he's not level 6. He's only level 5. What happened?
The death's hurting Ixmike a bit, and just being kept out of lane. And they're going to rotate, though, with the smoke. Winding their way towards Byver mid, wanting to take the sniper and dislodge him from the lane. Byver's starting to post up rather aggressively, and the smoke nearly now complete. They will end up sneaking their way into the tree line, just chilling here, and with the Fog Blink Dagger, this should be a pretty easy kill. Tornado's even going to hit just to make it easier. They'll hex him as well. Byver, dead to rights, will end up going down. Z-Freak cogged backwards, can't follow this up, and even forces out a Puck TP that later ended up getting cancelled. Big commitment there, bringing four heroes in, but they get the kill.
Moon still left unchecked, though, so that is a Midas and a Blink. Or actually, I don't know if he's going Blink yet, but it should be a Blink.
Swindle, yeah.
Oh yeah, Swindle. Sniper's actually fairly poor. He's 1 and 2, he's been having to run around a lot.
TP bottom earlier, yeah.
His CS is slightly more than Invoker's, but I think Invoker actually may be up on net worth almost.
I feel like that's where that one movement from Fog where they get the kill mid is so important. If that doesn't happen, Sniper's going to have way more farm. So with that, it kind of equalizes the lane and keeps him in check of it. And we'll see Roshan now. Ush going to solo this one with the Mask of Madness. Treads complete. Seems like that's the timing that he goes for. Get your Mask of Madness, Treads, Akila, and then you can just go into the mid. And this is with the mass stats, only the one value point in Blade Dance, which is really a value point. You get more than half of the total crit just from level 1. Impressive stuff. Oh, top lane, quick burst from Fog, he gets off the Impale as well as the Finger. At the same time, your Omni Knight ends up dying to a neutral creep because of that Zeus ultimate, killed off when he was about to finish the Centaur Conqueror. So it ends up being a 3-for-0 exchange. And they get even more than what they expected. Everything seeming to go well for Fire right now.
Holy cow, that was so quick. He died in half a second.
Yeah, Fog Blink Impale, and like as the Impale came out, he was already starting to zap him with the Finger.
It's all about the Fog Blink Dagger, it looks like. It's such an easy minigame for them once he gets his Blink, but if he doesn't have that Blink hero, no one else is really making the plays.
It's complete opposite at that point.
Still, we haven't seen the full strength of Complexity's lineup. Z-Freak has just not been at the right place ever. We haven't really seen him save anybody yet.
Yeah, they're going to need a total 360 to turn this one around.
Oh, God. They need a 720, I think. Two spins to do the trick.
Tornado EMP coming out on swindle. Just harassment for now, but it will be a bit irritating for the Slardar until he's repelled in the fights. Or gets that BKB. Fluff being pursued. Limp has a coil. Is he gonna go? Well, they're running in four. Fluff in their own neighborhood. And now trying to make his way out. Carrying two TPs, but neither can save him from this. Limp gets a much needed kill, and with that, can now work towards his flank.
Clockwork's also been very quiet, but he just hit level 6, 13 minutes in. He's also going for a blade mail, which is not the best choice versus an Omni Knight, but still pretty good item overall. I think it's better to kind of outlast the repel in the GA through the use of Force Staff. Mm-hmm. But if he thinks he can get solo kills, which is highly possible, especially considering the way that Complex is playing, then should be justifiable.
They begin their siege now with the double damage rune sniper. This tower, not too long for this world. And here comes that repelled Slardar, the Fishman, getting active. Hoping to see more of that from Complexity here if they want to turn this one around.
It's a level 1 repel.
And Jug already has Blink. Level 2 ultimate with the Blink. And the Mask of Madness.
Oh, they see TC. TC's out. He's surrounded.
Fog going at the same time. He gets up a two-hero impale, and he catches them both. They get slaughtered like cattle. TC is gripped, as you mentioned. He may end up going down here, but even if he does, Fogged with the Blink Dagger, again making the big plays. Moon Meander on the way out. A two-for-one thus far, and looking for more is Fluff. Now he's not looking for anything, apparently. Moon finally surrounded and finished off as Ush does isolate him in the trees. Make it a three-for-one. Fog again coming up. Aces for Fire. He has just been on. When they win, I feel like I haven't seen them win with Fog not having a good game. You know, like, they haven't been able to get away with him being a non-factor or a lower impact factor. Middle tower has fallen. So important to their teamfight execution. And the Lion pick continues to pay dividends. Definitely one of the go-to heroes on this patch, it feels.
Swindle kind of trying to wrap around from behind. Against Fogged and Fluff, though, with no BKB and no Repel, is going to be highly questionable.
Yeah, he goes in there, probably ends up just flat-out dying if he's not lucky. Unless he manages to get the Lion and there's someone to follow up. And we continue to see the Juggernaut all over the map. Ush was farming the enemy woods, now he's taking their Ancients. With the Blink Dagger going in, finding pickoffs around the map. Just seems like that perfect mix of like a hero that does pretty well in the lane, scales well with farm, but also just puts so much pressure on the enemy team in the mid-game. So they can't just sit back, accrue items for their sniper, and look to out-late game fire. Yasha's looking for more kills. Now Yasha. Is there anyone he can't solo kill at this point? I guess the Puck.
Yeah, it's, I mean, technically not Ami either.
That's true.
But
same time, I guess.
Fog
out his
is about to find Swindle.
Ush has his ulti in 7 seconds. Uh-oh. They're going to sleep him and run the hell away. And the hookshot's there from IX Mike. The Clockwork picks, doing a lot of work to initiate, but this time Fog doesn't get the jump. He gets silenced out by Limp. Still manages to find an impale onto two, bringing Z-Free Glow, but not finishing him off. Now Juggernaut slashing his way in, starting to get slowed and kited by Byver. Really slow. They're going to have another shrapnel too soon. And now they end up gripping Ush. They'll bring him down the first time. Can they bring him down the second? They've got a lot of follow-up here. This should be a double death for Ush unless he blinks out. Swindle's still in the chase, though. Blink, Crush will follow, and they amp him. Now, throwing out the Assassinate, the last hit going to Swindle. A big turn here for Complexity. Getting rid of that Aegis. Didn't have to buy back, though, on their Slardar for that. Don't think I mentioned that earlier.
They really need to control Roshan. I think they probably just need to do it, I think, but I don't really know how they can sneak it in without fire. Knowing, I mean, they have more damage than the Juggernaut if they can somehow pop the Lincolns and amp him. Actually, amp is only 5 second cooldown now, so he can just pop it himself. Point is, they need to do Roche. They can't let Juggernaut keep getting it. Also, the GA was just a tiny bit late on the Omni Knight.
Yeah, it still ended up being enough to turn the fight, and I guess the main concern is when TC is there. Like, if TC is there with the Orchid complete, these fights could go a lot differently and not favorably for Complexity. And they still just desperately need this Blink Dagger and Limp. Just has not been able to find any farm. Sitting almost even with the enemy Zeus. gold lead right now. Still pretty substantial for Fire, even though they took a few blows there. They lead by about 5k in net worth, 3k in experience, and the Midas just not quite able to compensate for that yet.
Yeah, I mean, Puck can survive in the offlane versus the Jug, but his trade-off is that he gets owned by Lion the rest of the game, so... I mean, it's nice,
the offlane Pucks in general have not been doing too hot in the America region. And it seems like it is mostly the Lion picks. I think we saw a Puck that went mid the other day.
Oh, they're smoked. These smoked are actually going to pop. That's awkward.
Oh, this is very awkward. Oh, okay. I'm awake. He's going to blink out. At the same time, our Puck does go mid limp, fighting with Seafreak for a bit of farm here. They want to get his blink out, but Seafreak's got his eyes on something a little more ambitious. Wanting to complete that Aghanim Scepter, it looks like. I guess the big worry for Complexity here is just going to be keeping the sniper. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Oh! Chug blinking out right as the sniper rounds the bend. Could have definitely killed him there. Little opt to play it safe. Yeah, this sniper is feeling very poor.
Yeah, he's extremely poor. Chug can just straight kill him with Blink Omni. Every time.
Unless the Omni Knight's in position. And that's just very difficult to pull off. When you've got Clockwork looking to disrupt your movements and positioning, and the Blink Dagger and us just catching them off guard.
Yeah, Omni Knight has so much burst, Omni Slash has so much burst so quickly.
You have to be ready with the ult, like, within a second or two. 2 seconds, it might be too late.
Fog with his casual 7 earned charges, just blowing people up every single finger cooldown. He is level 11 now! He's same level as the Midas Slardar.
Fog definitely making plays, and they're going to look to go in with their Juggernaut. Ush has an Omni Slash, blinks past for Vibers, but comes back and wrecks him. Gets the kill there nicely done. They search for more. Fire just a bit late to get those additional kills. The Slardar ends up going down mid earlier, as we saw. Now the Sniper falls. Two cores down in as many minutes. And there's no real trade at this point for Complexity. The heroes that are surviving are not going to be able to scale that well with items. They're not taking towers. There's no Roshan to grab right now. That's the other cool thing about this Juggernaut pick this game, is by sneaking, by soloing Rosh, Ush also denies it to a Slardar lineup, which normally is one of that hero's great strengths, is just being able to take Rosh first team very early.
They have so much burst that Omni Knight can't react in time. Like Blink, Blink Impale Finger and Zeus ult, as we've seen a couple of times already, is just too quick. Even like a godly Omni Knight can't repel and or heal in time.
Yeah, it's almost like he needs a Blink Dagger just to be able to get in position. But.
Or they have to play as 5, sit behind the repelled hero, or push with that sort of strategy. But that just leaves him open to getting owned by a Jug still.
Yeah, as well as the Clockwork. And you push into a Quasvex Invoker, things can get very scary. Speaking of TC, he's had a quiet game, but now the Orchid's out. And he's going to be starting to search for those pickoffs, joining the likes of the Juggernaut Clock. This Fire mosey on down this middle lane. Complexity will go for bottom. Swindle Melon's now repelled. Slowly working the creep wave. The issue for Complexity here is they do not push that quickly. Shrapnel not working on towers, if nothing else, is going to prevent them from having any kind of quick tower trading.
It's also just so obvious that they're all clumped together, because if they aren't, then Juggernaut will pick them off. Invoker will pick them off too, so they're forced to stay all together.
Another kill attempted. This time he cannot finish him off, but the Omni Slash will let you. GA, it's a bit late, and Z-Freak's gonna burn down to the Blade Fury. It's a double kill for Ush. 3 kills set up, and fake it 4! Ush getting his triple there. He'll bring down the Puck TP now as well. The Juggernaut is an absolute monster at this stage, and he's just going to go for a straight Scotty. Picks up a secondary ultimate orb.
See, this is where you would have liked to pick your push strat early. If you're going to go for a push strat and it's already been seen by other teams, like if they're trying to copy Cloud9, for example, then you really have to take in the first two picks, because their first two picks are not doing anything. Bane and Puck are just not having any sort of factor. Puck is just constantly dying. He gets like some damage in here and there, but in the end, he can't ever kill the Juggernaut. And Bane, he can't channel his grip. Not when all five of the heroes can stop his ult.
Yeah, it's not an easy game to get off of Fiend's Grip. And
Viper's about to die.
Playing TC, finding the solo kills, maybe? No. Looks like he didn't quite have the damage with the soul burn, but... Yeah, Viper doesn't really feel safe to go anywhere. TC's running around, running amok in this dire jungle, and... These teams just seem to have a very back-and-forth relationship when they play. You look at the series yesterday, game one, Fire looked great. Complexity looked pretty awful. Game two was a complete 180. And this game, it might be the same. Uh-oh, Swindle. He thought he had an easy solo kill. Not going to be the case. That finger's about to cool down. Will Fog get to use it? No. Didn't need it, but would have been pretty funny if he did. Everything just seems to be working for Fire this game. They get those kills bottom, and then what do you know? Roche is ready to go again. Ush easily takes it. There's no way to contest for Complexity. And then they start pressing. Slardar, no BKB, but trying to really force fights and... ends up getting punished for it. The world is smiling right now on Complexity. Or on Fire. Game one, it was all about Complexity.
Back to their old ways with the... we're lost in the mid-game and we don't know what to do.
And this is also where Fire just seemed to be at their best in this matchup. Is when it's more of like a spread-out map. There's not too many 5v5 team fights, and their individual pickoffs can shine. Like the solo smokes, Fog... going for plays like this with the quick zap on mid. Oh, that's some teamwork right there. And now they look for more. There's an Omni Slash coming out, and as Moon sleeps himself, he will get the deny, but that just means his poor ally Puck ends up taking the bullet for him, and so they lose two, make it three with that earlier death, and now comes the push. Devastation about to be wrought in this Complexity base. They'll look for the tier 3 mid. GG, well played. We're going to a deciding game three. Complexity just do not have it here, Ben.
Dire's middle tower. Yeah, there's not much more to say besides that. I think they didn't get what they wanted in their draft. Although it was a very similar lineup to what they had yesterday, they couldn't do what they wanted to do. They couldn't ever go in with a repelled guy. They couldn't save anyone with the Omni Knight. They couldn't ever kill the Jug with a Blink Puck or a Grip from the Bane. Like, all these things just completely flat.
And they couldn't really apply any pressure. Like, we saw the repel Blink Slaughter, like, once this game. Mm. Puck didn't even have a Blink Dagger until, like, 22 minutes.
It was really good on paper. I was like, man, Slaughter is going to own them. But it also might have been due to the Midas choice, too. But at the same time... Sniper didn't have any farm either. So.
Slaughter is also so bad at farming. So if you have to skip the Midas, unless you're just constantly CSing out game, but the nature of that here is kind of like a Night Stalker. You tend to go around looking for ganks and pickoffs, and you don't go Midas, it's difficult to keep up.
Or just shut Fog down.
Yeah. That seems, honestly, that seems to be the biggest key, is he gets the blink and magic happens for Fire. But with that said, guys, that wraps up game two, our deciding game three inbound. Who's going to be facing down against Cloud9 to represent America in the Dota 2 Asia Championships? We'll find out after this. That deciding game three coming your way in just a moment. Stick around. You're watching Beyond the Sun.